Past 3 years have been crazy when it comes to housing. We all know that that is true. Have you tried buying a house in this current crazy real estate markets? Have you sold one? Home appreciation went through the roof, pun intended. Inventory was way low. But the question is, what is the status of things right now? We have not looked at this in quite some time, well over a year. For instance, are the interest rates cooling things down in Florida because they've been on the way up? What about bidding wars? Are they gone for the most part? Because the number of homes on the market, are we seeing an increase at all in inventory? Has it stabilized in any way? And maybe you're asking yourself this question. Should I buy now or should I wait? And then there's the rental market. Mm. Well, we've got some experts in the studio with us, followers of Jesus and real estate experts. Larry Fischer, who's been with us previously from EXP Realty, and then also Cyndy Dube is with us as well. You work with Larry. You claim Larry as a coworker?
Sometimes.
Okay.
On the good days.
On the good days, right. Thanks, guys, for coming by the studio. We really appreciate that. It's great to see you. All right, Larry, let's just open things up here. Where are we at? Give us a bit of a look back, pandemic and coming out of the pandemic and where we are. Maybe what about inventory? What's it look like this morning?
So looking back in 2020 and 2021 and 22, we are right now below 2020, 2019, and 2021 inventory levels.
Yeah.
We are seeing interest rates at 7%, sometimes 6.5%. And a lot of those sellers who have a 2.5% or 3% interest rate, it's just not worth it for them to sell, to upgrade, or downsize to a higher interest rate. So that's creating a lot of pent-up frustration. And we're actually seeing some home price growth accelerated as a record low listings. Right now, we're about 24% year-over-year less listings on a national average. And that's creating a lot of pent-up frustration for buyers out there.
Exactly. Yeah. Why in the world would you want to sell, you know, if you've got a 2.8% interest rate or 3 or whatever? And then, yeah, just like you described it. So we've got a lot of these folks who aren't going anywhere. And that's clogging things up for everybody. Cyndy, have the prices come down at all, though? I mean, you know, in a significant way? It's just crazy. I know the inventory, as Larry mentioned, is coming into play with this. What are you seeing?
Yeah, so on the percent of homes that are appreciating, really take a look at Pinellas County, Hillsborough, Pasco. Those home prices are actually still up this year. So in Pinellas County, we're up 1.3%. Hillsborough 2.9, and then Pasco down slightly. So still a great time to buy and sell real estate here in Florida.
Okay, so it's just a small percentage, but still it's better to see the growth. And we have many other folks who listen. Of course, we have stations in Orlando, we got Sarasota, all the way down to Naples and all of that. The state of Florida in general, Larry, you mentioned migration over the past few years. And the state is growing. We all know that's true because we drive in the traffic every day, which it can kind of lead to you maybe losing your testimony a little bit. It could be challenging. but we have so many people coming to Florida. Is that still happening or has that leveled out?
Right now we're experiencing over 1,200 people a day moving to Florida, which will attest to the clogged streets and traffic congestion that we're experiencing. So with that migration, a lot of people are coming here because there's no state income tax. They're tired of the snow, the low barometric pressure, and all those factors that are making Florida that much more attractive is cause for that massive growth. And we're seeing that also create housing shortages. And, you know, one other factor that no one's talking about is Wall Street is buying neighborhoods.
And so they can rent out the homes?
Correct.
So
but they don't care. See, that I don't. If somebody comes and they want to live here, that's great. You want to live here. But if you're just buying houses and you don't care what happens in the infrastructure or all the other things, that bothers me.
And it's problematic because a normal home buyer will go to Lowe's, Home Depot. They'll support the local economy. They'll buy additional stuff. And it helps the stores, the Ace Hardwares. With Wall Street, they're going to do bare minimum to rent that property out. And makes it really frustrating for home ownership, for people who can't compete with Wall Street prices. And that's another factor that no one's really discussing right now, but we have to figure out some way to protect that so home ownership can be possible for people, because these rents are going up.
Ridiculous.
They're 26%. You know, right now we're looking at rents are equal to what it would cost to purchase a house. So, you know, if you pay rent for 30 years, you're not going to have that nest egg. And if you buy a house and get a 30-year mortgage, you're going to have something to give your family, which will create generational wealth. So that's, you know, a big thing that we're competing against with Wall Street right now.
Yeah.
I know we have a lot of people who are thinking, okay, well, the housing bubble, it's always a big question. Did we see a bubble? Do we potentially have a bubble? Where are we at with the bubble?
So 2008, we saw a little bit of a predatory lending, where you can go to one bank and get a first-time home buyer and go to the second bank. And they didn't have the crosstalk, nor did they have what is called an AMC, appraisal management company. And the AMC regulates is a third party from the lender, where before the lender could say, oh, it's appraised at this, and it would happen. But now there's regulation on that. There is an AMC required. So we're not seeing people get homes that shouldn't be buying homes. Uh-huh. We're seeing a mass migration where it's more difficult, and call it, it's not a bubble. It was low interest rates of 3%. Mm-hmm. I did a refi at 2.25.
Yeah. Wow.
And that's unheard of, where inflation was 8%. So it's like free money to do a refi.
Yeah.
And that created such a boom explosion for people trying to buy up land and property. So that's what really created the shortage of inventory. And then when we see the interest rates double, it created a pent-up frustration of listings.
Yeah.
And we're seeing other markets, like the luxury market is very soft right now because people aren't spending that much money. But if you look at other places like New Jersey, New York, California, where there's a migration, leaving it because it's a higher taxes.
Right.
Places like Texas, Tennessee, Florida being actually number one, is experiencing these housing shortages.
Do you think the COVID being cooped up in your house too had some kind of influence on people coming to Florida?
We saw a lot of people leave the states that were very strict, and they came to Florida and they ended up staying in Florida. Mm-hmm. We have several Airbnbs, and they were just renting out. And if you look at Manhattan, New Jersey, just those higher end cities, our prices are still relatively low compared to those cities, where those people just turned around and they bought here, and now they're here from a displacement from COVID. Yes.
It occurs to me that we may have some folks who would like to join in the conversation. I just kind of said because I know, generally speaking, it's always true, because that's what we have, a conversation. And so we have the phone lines open. Maybe you have a question for Larry and or Cindy. They are the experts, and they are in the hot seat right now. So if you have a question about buying a home, rental market, housing market in general, we'd love to hear from you. 888-777-6810. You can always, always, always join in the conversation. Have an open phone policy, always. In the studio with us, Larry Fischer from eXp Realty, along with Cindy Dube as well, who is an expert realtor. But better than that, they are followers of Jesus Christ. Amen. So they're a brother and sister in Christ. All right, so we've been talking about some of these issues regarding where we are with the housing market right now. And of course, real estate is always local, 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 but we've been talking in some generalities about Florida. We also want to give you an opportunity to weigh in on this, so we're going to go to the phones, guys. Let's see, Brandon in Sarasota first. Hi, Brandon. How are you doing this morning?
Good, good. How are you guys doing this morning?
Good,
fantastic.
Thanks.
Thanks for asking. What's up? What are you thinking?
Well, I was just curious. You know, I live in Sarasota, and what I noticed a lot of people or a lot of, I don't know if they're investors or whatnot, but they're buying a lot of these homes and they're turning they're just turning them to Airbnbs. So they're buying them really high.
We were just talking about that. Yeah. As a matter of fact. Yeah. So they're buying them really. Yeah. And so that's what's going on, Larry, with this.
So what we're seeing is Wall Street and investors are seeing opportunity to get an income, like a income producing property. And they're turning in these neighborhoods into Airbnbs. And it's really disrupting the neighborhood because of the traffic with the transient type of folks that are coming in.
And can you imagine if that was your neighbor?
Right.
Okay. I put that in air quotes. Mm-hmm. And you have it rotating through every week. You've got somebody new. That would be difficult, I think. That would be tough.
A lot of people are moving out of the neighborhoods, and we've seen neighborhoods torn apart because with these partygoers, because they're just coming to have a good time. It's Florida.
Yeah.
And they're just creating a big a nuisance in the neighborhood with traffic and trash, and they're just not taking care of it. So we're seeing neighborhoods and then city governments are now putting different laws into effect to combat and try to outlaw the short-term rentals as well.
Yeah.
Okay, this is interesting. Thanks, Brandon, for the question. Yeah. Brandon from Sarasota. Now we're going to Brandon, listening in San Antonio, Texas, who wants to move potentially to Sarasota. Hey, Brandon in San Antonio, how are you?
Doing great. How about you?
Doing fantastic. Good, welcome to the conversation. All right, what's up?
Awesome. Thanks. Yeah, we just had a quick question. We're actually from San Antonio and wanted to see about moving into Sarasota. We've been looking for property for actually several years now, even before the spike in inflation, and wanted to see if it's even still a viable option or a wise option to really still buy in Sarasota with the inflation that's actually occurred.
Well, right now, as the top 10 areas in the U.S., Sarasota is actually number 8. And there's since between January and March, they've had 4,900 people move in just in that short amount of time. And right now, we're just dealing with scarcity, supply, and demand. We are seeing prices go up. We are still seeing bidding wars. And it's because there just is not enough property out there. So rents are going up. They're not going down. And that's creating the scarcity. But if you're looking to buy, these interest rates can't stay high as long as, you know, where they're at now. I think we're also going to see a boom on sales when interest rates drop because people are going to take advantage of the lower interest rates. Mm-hmm. So it's a tough answer. But I think with home ownership, it's always a win because at the end of 30 years, paying 30 years of rent, you have nothing. But a 30-year fixed mortgage, you have something that you can have for generational wealth for your family.
You know what I've noticed as well? If you go to Redfin, you can go to the Market Insights page, and they have the temperature of the market. And even, and you're talking about potential bidding wars and low inventory, but when I was checking my own area, which was red hot for the longest time, I hadn't checked it in forever and a day, it's like, okay, when it used to be like 88 out of 100 mm-hmm. in terms of temperature,
yeah.
Now it's like, I don't know, 40-something along those lines. And yet, are there still bidding wars? How does that all shake out?
So even in Pinellas County yesterday, we had a duplex, and there was 3 offers over asking price, and the cash offer at asking price won. So we are experiencing bidding wars, and it was $500,000.
Is the market temperature based on the number of sales? Is that what it is then? And people are, and not as many homes are being sold because of what we're talking about, the interest rates and things like this and low inventory. So that brings down the market temperature?
The market temperature is going to be set on a factor of things. Supply and demand, what the interest rates are, what the scarcity is. But right now, you know, looking at a different area, let's say like San Francisco, their market temperature is going to be a lot less because they have an outflow of 31,000 people between January and March. So they're going to be a cold market temperature. Where Miami, Florida, they've had 8,600 people move in from January to March. So that's going to set the temperature of that area.
Right. And whatever's available is, you know, I mean, that's, we get back to inventory, you know, whatever's available. Cyndy, I wanted to ask you about something too.
Sure.
I want to get your expertise on this. What was in the news about the deal where folks with poor credit, in some of the articles, I don't remember the specifics. I just kind of noticed the headline on this. The bullet point is, it's like, okay, we're helping out folks who have bad credit, helping them get a mortgage, and this will somehow penalize folks who have good credit. What's going on with this?
I'm so glad you asked about that because I feel like it's the thing that everyone is talking about right now. And they're saying, oh, I'm just going to go run up my credit and I'm going to stop paying bills so I can, you know, get a better deal when it comes to financing a home. And that's just not what's happening. So I'm glad you asked about that. So let's debunk kind of that social media frenzy that's out there right now. what is actually happening is high credit borrowers are still paying significantly less than low credit borrowers. What's happening is the gap between those two types of borrowers is actually shrinking. So people with those higher credit scores, in most cases, except approximately 15 to 20%, actually saw no change in the cost of their mortgage. Where people with those lower credit scores were given easier access, they're still paying significantly more for that mortgage. So those things that you're seeing out there, the memes, all the stuff like that, it really is not the case. Don't go tanking your credit. If you do have questions, you know, talk to a lender and get some advice and go that way.
That's great.
So if you have bad credit or less good credit, you're going to be paying a lot more in your mortgage every month.
You definitely are. Yeah. So it's still way more beneficial to have a higher credit score and keep that score up.
We also should point out that it's principal and interest, and then you've got property taxes, and then you've got homeowners insurance. Oh, my goodness. We're in a crisis when it comes to homeowners insurance. It's so expensive. So we have to be thinking about that, don't we? I mean, we have to add everything up. What's in our budget? What can we afford?
Exactly. And I always, when talking to buyers, definitely suggest getting pre-approved first before you start that home search so you know exactly what you qualify for. You know, Larry kind of touched on the fact that inventory is low here in Florida, and those houses, you know, in the $400,000 and below range, they're still selling fast. We're still seeing multiple offers. Are we seeing some things like price reductions and seller concessions again? We are, but Florida market is still hot, so it's a great time to be in Florida.
This whole idea of I'm going to waive the inspection and all of that, those days are gone?
I would say you still see a lot of all of it, right? Those people that will still offer over ask, it'll kind of, you know, lessen the contingencies on the file, but Larry, you want to chime in a little on that one?
Yes, it is still competitive. And, you know, you can say, yeah, we'll go in with no inspection period. However, there's still a loan contingency. And with that loan contingency, you still have to get a 4-point. And that 4-point is going to look at your plumbing, your electric, your roof, and your HVAC.
Right.
If you have an issue on the 4-point, you get loan denial because you can't insure the property. You don't get a loan. Mm-hmm. So if you're smart about it and to know how to really navigate that contract, you can go in with no inspection. However, there's still caveats to that. But one thing was not mentioned was the flood insurance. So Pinellas County, 27% of the properties in Pinellas County require flood insurance. So FEMA also redrew the map a few years back.
That
changed a lot of us. And flood insurance is going up significantly. So that's one thing that people need to be cognizant of. Are you on the fringe of a flood insurance area, AE, and what does that look like? And the biggest thing for any home buyer out there, always assume the flood policy of the seller. Don't go and get your own new policy, because when you get your own new policy, it's going to be written at a much higher level.
Oh, okay.
So you can't assume the flood. What happens, though? Well, I guess if you assume it, then it's going to stay at that rate?
Correct. You're grandfathered in.
Grandfathered in. Okay,
oh,
great.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
All right. So we're going to get two more questions here. Maybe you have a question, and Larry and Cyndy would be more than happy to answer that question regarding real estate, housing, et cetera. We haven't even touched on the rental market yet. Oh, my goodness. So much to talk about. Hey, what's the housing market like in Hungry Joe, Montana?
That's a good question.
Larry or Cyndy, you want to weigh in on that? You're the experts.
I need to Google that.
Yeah.
Exactly. Go back to the phones. Let's go to Anonymous in Plant City. Hey, Anonymous, good morning to you.
Good morning.
What's your question?
Well, I have a couple related to rising costs and interest rates, et cetera. We're at a point now where prices of mortgage are going and interest rates and insurance are going up so high that eventually, where's the cap? Because working Americans are coming to a point where they're not going to afford to stay in their homes, and there's going to be a mass amount of foreclosures. I don't know if I'm the only one thinking this or it's just not being talked about.
What do you think, Larry?
It's unfortunate with the interest rates where they are going and the fiscal policy and what they're doing. It's going to be isolated. We're going to see other parts of the nation where there are foreclosures because there's migration leaving. I would be very cognizant and aware of what those trends are. So if you were to look at what those temperatures are of top 10 areas are people are moving from. From top of the list is San Francisco, New York, Los Angeles, Washington, D.C., Boston. But if you check, if it's actually – it's on redfin.com under market demand on housing to show the outflow, it is unfortunate. But the areas that have the higher concentration of population growth, those are areas you're not going to see the foreclosures because the demand and scarcity is there.
Let's talk about the rental markets. We haven't even touched on that. Sky-high rents – are they going to be coming down? I know usually rents always go up. They rarely ever come back down again. But because they're so high in so many places, Cyndy, what's happening with this?
So with our rental market, the average rents are around $2,200 a month. So I kind of took a look out there. Pinellas Park's at $2,166, Tampa about $2,300, and then Newport Richey is about $2,200.
What do you get for that amount of money?
Not a lot, no.
I set you up for that,
you know,
didn't I?
Yeah. You kind of did, right? So probably more so your typical three-bedroom, two-bath, about, what, 1,200 square feet, you think, Larry?
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
So our rental market is actually still very warm. However, those rent prices are still increasing, and in Pinellas alone, we've seen an average of $266 a month, and I think we will see those amounts continue to rise.
Yes, and on a national average, if you look back all the way to 2017, rents have gone up 5%. It did drop down in 2021, and then 2022 went up 15%. But year over year, right now, we're at 6%. So if interest rates are scaring you, look at what the percentage is of rents that are going up year over year. But yeah, if you could lock in a 30-year fixed, that's – for me, it makes sense, personally. Well,
when I bought my first house years ago, I mean, it was 7% was my interest rate. And we didn't even blink at that. We thought, okay, well, that is normal. So historically, the interest rates are still, even though we're jumping up and down, they're historically still fairly low. The problem is you combine that with the price of the house itself. That's when you get into the weeds.
And my parents had a double-digit interest rate. But what the difference is – they didn't have a 3% interest rate 2 years ago like we experienced. So people do not want to get rid of that 3% interest rate because the new interest rate is 6%. It's double that. So there's a holding cost. It doesn't make financial sense to them to release that low interest rate to double their interest rate on an already expensive market.
Right, right. Yeah.
You guys, we've got to have you back at some point. I'm getting the hard rap.
Yeah.
We have to wrap this thing up.
Yes,
like,
yes,
no,
it's very late.
Yeah. But we need to have you back periodically. Yeah, one more thought. Final thought, Larry. Quick one.
Throw a plug?
Yeah, go ahead.
So if you Google Military Veteran Realtor Team, Google Military Veteran Team, and check us out. We really would appreciate to help you out. And
you're on the first page of Google.
Yes, we were on the first page of Google in the world.
All right, excellent. Cyndy and Larry, we appreciate you being in the studio with us. We hope that this has been a blessing to you. And remember, you know, facts are your friends, but at the end of the day, the Lord is the one who leads. He will make a way where there seems to be no way. He's really good at that.